Hello everyone, welcome to LMS. I am Madhuri Abhiyar, working as lecturer in Government Polytechnic, Chitradurga. This is Advanced Communication, session number 7 of Unit 4, Satellite Communication. So let's see the contents of the session. First we'll have a recap of previous session. We discussed about TT&C subsystem, power subsystem and applications payload. In this session, we'll be discussing about block diagram of a satellite earth station. We'll be discussing about various subsystems available in a satellite earth station. First, we'll have a recap of previous session. Telemetry tracking and command, that is TT&C subsystem. This subsystem allows a ground station to monitor and control conditions in the satellite. So the function or objective of using a TT&C subsystem in a satellite is to monitor and control the operations of a satellite. Power subsystem is a vital subsystem which provides the power required for working of a satellite. So we all know where there are various subsystems available in a satellite. So power subsystem will provide the power to all the subsystems. Applications payload, it is that part of the satellite that carries the desired instrumentation required for performing its intended function. So application payload is nothing but an instrument in a satellite for which will perform the functions or operation of a satellite for which the satellite has been launched. Andre satellite application yaduke launch madidare aa application related operations na perform martakanta instrument na enanta karitivi applications payload anta karitivi. Now we'll discuss about satellite earth station. Earth stations are a part of satellite network's ground segment. So we have two segments. One is space segment and ground segment. In space segment we have satellites orbiting in their respective orbits. In ground segment we have earth stations which will be controlling and monitoring the operations of satellite, and also it will be communicating the information between the users and satellite. Earth stations, the function of an earth station is to receive information from or transmit information to the satellite. So earth station main function andre satellite ge information na kalisodu uplink signals mulaka athwa satellite inda bartakanta downlink signals inda information na receive maadkoltakkantadu. So earth station do function agirutte. Satellite earth station, the main subsystems of a satellite earth station are, so we have six various subsystems available in a satellite earth station. Satellite earth station alli athwa ground station alli six different subsystems irutte. Yavadu andre ground communication equipment GCE transmit subsystem, ground communication equipment GCE receive subsystem. Next we have receive subsystem, antenna subsystem, power subsystem. So these are the various subsystems available in a satellite earth station. Earth station alli irthakanta subsystems irutte eshtu 6 subsystem ide. GCE transmit subsystem irutte, GCE receive subsystem irutte, next to receive subsystem irutte, antenna subsystem matte power subsystem. So this is the block diagram of a satellite earth station. On the satellite earth station in the block diagram idu. So we can see here we have GCE transmit subsystem. So this is a GCE transmit subsystem which is connected to transmit subsystem. So this is the transmit subsystem. It is connected to antenna subsystem. Next, this is also connected to receive subsystem. So this is receive subsystem. This receive subsystem is connected to GCE receive subsystem. So this is the GCE receive subsystem. So now we'll discuss the functions of each subsystem individually. So first subsystem we have is ground communication equipment GCE transmit subsystem. GCE andre ground communication equipment anta. So first yadide GCE transmit subsystem bage discuss madalo. The baseband inputs from terrestrial networks are multiplexed and applied to a modulator along with the carrier oscillator operating at the intermediate frequency. So we can see here in GCE transmit. So this is the GCE transmit subsystem. We have various baseband inputs, means the information signals or the baseband signals from the different users are connected or given as input for this multiplexer. GCE transmit subsystem ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸರ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟರ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸರ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಯೂಸರ್ಸಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಅಥವಾ ಬೇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಬೇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ದಲ್ಲೇ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್, ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್, ದ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್. ಸೊ ದ ಬೇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಯೂಸರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ multiplexer. So this will combine this different baseband inputs and convert it into a single signal. One many inputs ಇದೆ, one output ಆಗಿ single output ಆಗಿ convert ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಯಾವುದು multiplexer. So that multiplexed baseband input signal is given to modulator. So the function of this modulator is to perform modulation. So the inputs to this modulator are, we have multiplex baseband input and carrier oscillator. ಅಂದರೆ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟರ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ನ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರ್ತೀವಿ, ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಏನು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸರಿಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದನ್ನು ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್. ಸೊ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಆಪರೇಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ. ಸೊ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ಸಬ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸೊ ಜಿಸಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಏನಿದಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್, ಅದನ್ನು ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಅಪ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟರ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಅಪ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟರ್ ದ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ, ಯೂಶಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ 70 ಮೆಗಾಹರ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಯುಲೇಟರ್, ಆಸ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು, ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯರ್ ಆಸಿಲೇಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ. Usually 70 megahertz is preferred for intermediate frequency. So that intermediate frequency after modulation is applied to this up converter. So next, second subsystem we have is transmit subsystem. The IF signal, that is intermediate frequency signal from GCE transmit subsystem, is applied to an up converter mixer circuit with its local oscillator tuned to generate the uplink frequency. So the modulator output from this GCE transmit is applied to a up converter here. So this is in the transmit subsystem. So the function of this up converter is to convert the intermediate frequency to uplink frequency. So the inputs for this up converter are this intermediate frequency signal and the local oscillator signal. ಸೊ ಈ ಅಪ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟರ್ ಏನು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಏನು ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಜಿ ಸಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ಸಬ್ಸಿಸ್ಟಮಿಂದ, ಅದನ್ನು ಅಪ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಫ್ರೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಿಗೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವುದ್ರದ್ದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಪ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟರ್ದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಅಪ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಬೈನರ್. All the up converted signals are then applied to a power combiner which combines all the RF signals into the final signal to be transmitted. So this up converter output, that is the uplink signal, will be applied to combiner. So we will be having a set of up converters. All the uplink signals from individual up converters are applied to a combiner. So it will combine all the uplink signals into a single signal. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು ನೀವು ಈ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಬೈನರ್ ಇದೆ, ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಪ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಪ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅಪ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ನ ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಯಾವುದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಪವರ್ ಕಂಬೈನರ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಂಬೈನರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಟು ಅ ಡ್ರೈವರ್. ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ, ದ ಕಂಬೈನ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎಫ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಟು ಅ ಹೈ ಪವರ್ amplifier. So the function of this high power amplifier is to amplify this uplink signal, because the signal has to be transmitted from earth station to satellite. So for that we have to convert this low power signals into a high power signals. For that we have a high power amplifier. So that is given to a band pass filter. The function of this band pass filter is to remove any intermodulation harmonics or any unwanted frequency components present in the uplink signal. So BPF en madutte band pass filter, BPF andre adu unwanted frequency components athwa intermodulation components enadru frequency components ittu andre unwanted frequency components na filter madutte adu BPF. The output signal is applied to the antenna subsystem through a band pass filter. So that is given to the antenna subsystem. So the output of this band pass filter is applied to this antenna subsystem. Next we'll discuss about antenna subsystem. The antenna subsystem consists of the parabolic reflector, the horn antenna, related mounts and a polarized diplexer. So in antenna subsystem we have parabolic reflector will be there, horn antenna will be there, and a diplexer is used. So the function of this diplexer is to isolate the high power transmitter from highly sensitive receiver. The output of this band pass filter, the uplink signal from the band pass filter is applied to a diplexer. The diplexer permits both the transmitter and receiver to use the same antenna. It isolates the highly sensitive receiver from the high power transmitter. So the function, why we are using diplexer, means you can see we have a common antenna for both transmission and reception. Andre transmit madlike matte receive madlike common antenna use madidaga, now transmitter inda kalustakanta signal yavaglu high power signal irutte. ರಿಸೀವರ್ ಯಾವುದಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಹೈಲಿ ಸೆನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ರಿಸೀವರ್. ಸೊ ಡೈಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸರ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೈ ಪವರ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರಿಂದ ಅದು ರಿಸೀವರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಎಂಟರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೈಲಿ ಸೆನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ರಿಸೀವರ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ರಿಸೀವರ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಐಸೋಲೇಷನ್ನ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಡೈಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸರ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದ ಹೈ ಪವರ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ should go to the antenna, it should not enter this receiver subsystem. So that is why a diplexer is used. So it is used for isolation between high power transmitter and highly sensitive receiver. So the function of this antenna is to send the uplink signal to the satellite, and when it is receiving a downlink signal from the satellite, the antenna will pick that received or downlink signal and give it to the receiving subsystem. Next we have a receive subsystem. The earth station antenna receives the low level modulated RF carrier in the downlink frequency. So the frequency downlink signal from the satellite will be received by the antenna, and it is sent to the diplexer, and through diplexer it is sent to this receive subsystem. So the downlink signal, it is a weak signal received by the antenna. So we have a band pass filter for filtering of unwanted frequency components. The output of this band pass filter is given to LNA. LNA means low noise amplifier. The low noise amplifier is used to amplify the weak received signals and improve the signal to noise ratio. So the function of this low noise amplifier, in this receive subsystem we have a low noise amplifier. So its function is to amplify the received downlink signal to a good signal to noise ratio. ಒಂದು ಹೈ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಅಥವಾ ಒಂದು ಗುಡ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಟು ನಾಯ್ಸ್ ರೇಷಿಯೋಗೆ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ನ ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು LNA ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೋ ನಾಯ್ಸ್ ಆಂಪ್ಲಿಫೈಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಟು ದ ಪವರ್ ಡಿವೈಡರ್. ದ LNA ಡ್ರೈವ್ಸ್ ಅ ಪವರ್ ಡಿವೈಡರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟ್ಸ್ ದ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ವಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ಸಬ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್, ಸೊ ವಿ had a combiner. So it used to combine all the uplink signals from various up converters. So similarly, when the transmitting earth station is combined all the uplink signals, so when it is received by the satellite earth station, the receiving subsystem has to split those signals. So we have a power divider. ಸೊ ಏನು ಡೌನ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಆ ಡೌನ್ಲಿಂಕ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಬೇರೆ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಅರ್ಥ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನಿಂದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ಅರ್ಥ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟರ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿರುತ್ತೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ನ ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕಳಿಸಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಅರ್ಥ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಅದನ್ನು ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಾಗ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ನ ಆ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಸ್ಪ್ಲಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ದ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪವರ್ ಡಿವೈಡರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಟು ಅ ಡೌನ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟರ್. The power divider feeds several down converters which translate the received signals to an intermediate frequency. So as you can see here, the output of the power divider is applied to down converter. So similarly, we'll be having a set of down converters. So the function of this down converter is to convert the downlink signal to intermediate frequency signal. So the output for this down converter are input for the down converter are signal from the power divider, that is the downlink frequency and the local oscillator frequency. So it will convert the downlink signal into a intermediate frequency signal. So that IF signal is applied to a band pass filter for filtering purposes. So this is about the receive subsystem. Next, the output from this band pass filter is applied to this GCE receive subsystem. So, ground communication equipment GCE receiver subsystem. The IF signal is sent to the demodulator for getting baseband signals. So, in GCE receive, we have a demodulator and demultiplexer. Okay. So, the output from this band pass filter or the output from this receive subsystem, it is an intermediate frequency signal. It is applied to the demodulator. It will be performing demodulation of the signal and will be getting the baseband outputs. So, the output of this demodulator is fed to the demultiplexer. So, the demodulator output enide adanna demultiplexer ge apply martare. So, demodulator en madutte en modulate aagi bandirutte signal downlink signal adanna en madutte demodulation maadi baseband signals ge convert madutte. This is fed to the demultiplexer, which is used for sending the baseband signals to their respective destinations. So, what happens is when the transmitting earth station is sending the signals, it will be multiplexing all the baseband inputs. And then transmitting earth station in madutte athwa source earth station in madirutte ella users inda bartakkanta signals na multiplex madirutte. So illi receive maadkondaga receiver alli irthakkanta athwa GCE receiver subsystem irthakkanta demultiplexer en maadbekagutte andre a combined multiplexed signal enide adanna demultiplexing maadbekagutte. So adu en madutte demultiplex maadibittu corresponding athwa respective destinations ge baseband outputs na kodta hogutte. So the output from this demodulator is the baseband output, which is multiplexed at the transmitting earth station. Transmitting earth station adanna multiplex maadi kalisirthakanta signal irutte. So the function of this demux is to demultiplex those multiplexed baseband signals. Okay, so the output is the baseband output. It will be demultiplexed by this demultiplexer. So the output of this demultiplexer will be given to the corresponding destinations or receiver. Last subsystem we have is power subsystem. The power subsystem supplies power to all the equipments. So there are various equipments or subsystems in a earth station. So this subsystem will provide power to all the subsystems or equipments. The primary sources of power are the standard AC power lines. So the primary source of power will be AC power line. This subsystem also consists of emergency power sources such as diesel generators, batteries and inverters to ensure continuous operation during power failures. So during power failures or during emergency situations, there will be diesel generators, batteries and inverters for backup power facility. So this is the power subsystem. The primary source will be AC power line. Also we'll be having generators, diesel generators will be there, inverters will be there, batteries will be there for emergency power backup. Okay. So this is about the block diagram of a satellite earth station. So we have GCE transmit subsystem, ट्रांसमिट सबसिस्टम, एंटेना सबसिस्टम, रिसीव सबसिस्टम, GCE रिसीव सबसिस्टम एंड पावर सबसिस्टम. सो द फंक्शन ऑफ GCE ट्रांसमिट इज टू रिसीव द बेस बैंड इनपुट्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट यूजर्स. वी हैव अ मल्टीप्लेक्सर, इट विल मल्टीप्लेक्स ऑल द बेस बैंड इनपुट्स इंटू अ सिंगल सिग्नल दैट इज गिवन टू अ मॉड्यूलेटर. इट विल मॉड्यूलेट द बेस बैंड इनपुट सिग्नल टू अ इंटरमीडिएट फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो वी हैव अ कैरियर ऑसिलेटर ऑपरेटिंग एट इंटरमीडिएट फ्रीक्वेंसी. यूजुअली 70 megahertz will be the preferred intermediate frequency signal. So the output from this modulator is an intermediate frequency signal applied to a up converter in the transmit subsystem. So the function of this up converter is to convert the intermediate frequency signal to uplink signal. So the we'll be having many up converters. All the outputs from the up converters or the uplink signals from different up converters are applied to a combiner, which is applied to a HPA, have a high power amplifier. So it will amplify the signal. So we have a driver which acts as a driver for amplifier, because these are low frequency signals operating here. It has to be converted into, low power signals. This has to be amplified to a high power level. So we have a driver. So the high power amplified signal is given to a band pass filter for filtering of unwanted frequency. Next, it is applied to the antenna subsystem. We have a diplexer here. The function of diplexer is to isolate the high power transmitter from highly sensitive receiver, as we are using a common antenna for transmitter and receiver part. So the uplink signal from the diplexer is given to antenna. It will send the uplink signal to the satellite. So similarly, another earth station will be sending signals to this earth station. So the downlink signal from the satellite will be received by this antenna. It is given to a diplexer. The output of this diplexer or the received downlink signal will be given to this receive subsystem. So we have a bandpass filter for filtering of unwanted frequency. Next, it is given to a low noise amplifier, which will amplify the signal to good or high signal to noise ratio. It is the downlink signal is applied to a power divider. It will split those downlink signal which were combined at the transmitter in a transmitting earth station. So the output of this power divider is given to various down converters. The function of this down converter is to convert the downlink signal to intermediate frequency signal. So it is given to a bandpass filter for filtering. So next, it is applied to a demodulator in GCE receive subsystem. It will demodulate the intermediate frequency signal and the output will be the baseband output. So that signal has to be demultiplexed. So we have a demultiplexer, and that individual signals will be given to the corresponding destinations. So this is the function of various subsystem in a satellite earth station. The summary of the session is, we discussed or we studied about block diagram of a satellite earth station. So we have six major subsystem. So GCE transmit subsystem and transmit subsystem, this forms the transmitter part of earth station. Earth station in the transmitter part yadirutte, GCE transmit subsystem matte transmit subsystem. Earth station receiver part yadirutte, receive subsystem matte GCE receive subsystem. So to communicate or to exchange signals between satellite and earth station, we have a antenna subsystem. And to provide power to all the various equipments or subsystem, we have a power subsystem. So these are the subsystems having different functions, performing various operations in a satellite earth station. Expected questions: list different subsystem of a satellite earth station. So we have to list out the six different subsystem in a satellite earth station. Explain the general block diagram of a satellite earth station. So you have to write the block diagram and explain the function of each subsystem. Now let's have a quiz. So you have to abbreviate this. GCE stands for, so you have to abbreviate the full form of GCE. So GCE stands for, the right answer is ground communication equipment. GCE and then ground communication equipment anta. Diplexer is used to, so what is the function of diplexer in this satellite earth station? Used to isolating high power transmitter and highly sensitive receiver. Because we will be using common antenna for transmitting and receiving. What is the use of mixer in transmit subsystem? So we have a mixer in transmit subsystem. So we have to guess the function of the mixer. So hope you have guessed the right answer. It is used to generate uplink signal. So in transmit subsystem there is an up converter which will convert the intermediate frequency signal to uplink signal. Next, a satellite signal transmitted from an earth station to satellite is, so what do you call the signal transmitted from earth station to satellite? So the right answer is uplink. So the link between earth station and satellite is called as the link from earth station to satellite is called as uplink. What is the use of mixer in receive subsystem? So we have a receive mixer in receive subsystem also. So you have to guess the function of that mixer. So the right answer is to generate IF signal from downlink signal. So in transmitter we'll generate IF signal from uplink signal from intermediate frequency. In receiver what we'll do, we'll convert the IF downlink signal to IF signal. Next, the function of LNA is, that is low noise amplifier in the receive subsystem. What is the function of this LNA? So it is to amplify the received signal with a high signal to noise ratio. Next, you have to guess whether it is true or false. The function of demultiplexer is to distribute the signals to their respective destination. So the answer is true. So we have a demultiplexer in GCE receive subsystem. It will perform demultiplexing of the baseband inputs and send the baseband outputs. The baseband outputs will be given to the respective or corresponding destination. So hope you have understood the topics covered in this session. Thank you.